So I'll start off this video by saying this. It's not the end of the world, and the sky isn't falling, but it damn sure feels like it. Bruins lose 5-3 to the Dallas Stars. Now there's a lot of stuff I need to talk about in this episode. And honestly, it's going to be a little bit scatterbrained. I don't really want to stick to the normal breaking everything down just because so much has happened. We'll start off by saying this. The Bruins yet again lose at home. They still only have one home game, and I wish they could just play on the road for the rest of the season. And then it gets even worse when you know that they play 5 straight games at TD Garden later on this month. Tuukka Rask, once again, did not have his greatest game. That, of course, goes hand-in-hand with the defense not having their greatest game, and in particular, the penalty kill not having their greatest game. I'll address all three of these things. Tuukka Rask, you know he's better than this. Everybody knows he's better than this. I don't get what's going on. It's not a Sergei Bobrovsky situation at this point, but it is so goddamn frustrating to see him struggle. As far as the defense goes, we knew we were going to have issues. And while Colin Miller looks great, and I'll talk about him more later, you're still having to ice essentially a pretty young defense with Colin Miller, Kevin Miller, Joe Morrow, even Torey Krug. And perhaps young isn't the right word, but inexperienced is certainly fitting for all four of those players. Dennis Seidenberg is still out. And in this game, you know, they show up in the press box. Hey, here's Dennis Seidenberg eating a sandwich. Well, right next to him, Zach Trotman. He's the only other option. And he's still, I think, 24, 25 years old. Still inexperienced, still young. This team needs to get defense. And again, I mentioned it in previous videos, the last point there that I made was the penalty kill. I mentioned in a previous video just how strange it is for the power play to be doing this well and for the penalty kill to be doing this poorly. It's essentially the exact opposite of what it's been for the past couple of years. And honestly, I think I preferred the penalty kill, particularly after this game where Dallas's power play was just dominant. The Bruins had some good power play chances as well, and again, we'll get into that. But Dallas's power play made mincemeat out of the Bruins' penalty kill tonight. So getting into this game, and the first thing we have to mention is that David Pastrnak is out. There are conflicting reports saying a bruised bone in his foot, a small fracture, a flat-out broken foot. Nobody seems to know, but David Pastrnak simply isn't healthy, and that doesn't really help his case when he kind of started to struggle a little bit, particularly defensively, making some mistakes as a young player would. But we know how Claude Julien doesn't exactly love to give young players a chance. However, in this situation they did, as Alexander Kokolchev gets the call up, the AHL's leading scorer. He has been tearing it up. He needs to make that jump to the NHL. Now, the big thing to talk about in this game, as far as the Bruins go at least, because there's certainly a big player to talk about as far as Dallas goes, or at least a couple of them, but one in particular, I think you all know who I'm going to mention. As far as the Bruins go, Chris Kelly, within 2 minutes, goes down to injury, and it's come out now. He is going to be out 6 to 8 months with a broken left femur and just a freak injury, a freak accident that honestly looks like it's going to end his career. He's a UFA after the season. His contract's coming to an end with Boston. I doubt we ever see him in a Bruins uniform again, and whether or not he'll be able to make a comeback and get in with an NHL team next season. But as far as Chris Kelly goes, I know a lot of people were down on him. I thought he was doing relatively well this season. And again, you cannot undervalue leadership and defensive ability, and Chris Kelly, like it or not, is one of the best defending forwards on this team, a staple of the penalty kill. Now, of course, you can say, oh, well, the penalty kill is shit. You're not wrong, but it's even worse, and it's going to be even worse without him on this team. And without a doubt, the Bruins being down a man the whole game certainly didn't help. So now we'll get to the fun part. Early on in the first period, Tyler Seguin strikes a beautiful snipe through the legs of Kevin Miller, who continues to struggle this season. And the bottom line is, when it comes to Tyler Seguin, and you're a Bruins fan, you're on one or two sides of the argument, more than likely. It's fuck Tyler Seguin, or it's god damn it, why did we trade Tyler Seguin? I'm on the god damn it, why did we trade Tyler Seguin side. I don't care what your excuse is. I don't care that Louis Erickson, and yeah, I haven't gotten into it yet. I don't care if Louis Erickson scored 2 goals. Trading Tyler Seguin is going to go down as one of the worst trades in NHL history. It eclipses the Joe Thornton deal, and it seemed impossible to ever eclipse the Joe Thornton deal in terms of just stupid fucking decisions. Louis Erickson's been decent here, and he might re-sign with Boston in the offseason. He cannot even come close to replicating what Tyler Seguin can do. Joe Morrow is decent. He's a 6th-7th guy at best right now, but he's still young. Matt Frazier isn't even here anymore. At the end of the day, this trade is so goddamn one-sided. Tyler Seguin has 6 hat tricks as a Dallas Star. He's only played 164 games in Dallas. He has 6 hat tricks. He is the first player from the 2010 draft to eclipse 300 points. And of course, I'll just remind you of who was in that draft. Taylor Hall goes number one, which, goddammit, he would have fit in better with the Bruins, and they probably wouldn't have traded him. Ryan Johansson, Jeff Skinner, Vladimir Tarasenko. I mean, honestly, what is that? I'm not going to keep hammering home the point. We all know the Seguin trade was fucking stupid. But it's going to get brought up every single time the Bruins play Dallas. And it very well should. That needs to be a consistent reminder. And Tyler Seguin himself certainly reminded them tonight of what they passed up on. Now, Tyler Seguin gets that early goal, but a minute and 28 seconds later, Colin Miller gets his first NHL goal, a faceoff one directly to him, gets the slap shot to go home, a save Lettinen probably should have had, but it's, again, his first NHL goal. He's looked really good so far, of course, acquired in the Lucic deal. I really like what we have in Colin Miller, and to be honest, I'm shocked LA gave him up. Knowing Lucic only had 1 year left on his deal, knowing that they have to worry about potentially losing Anze Kopitar, and they gave up a stud, a genuine stud like this guy. Bruins get a late power play chance, and again, the red-hot power play strikes again. David Krejci with a steal along the sideboards, gets it back to Patrice Bergeron. He feeds Torrey Krug, who gets a shot on net, and Louis Erickson cleans it up. 2-1 Boston to end the first period. And again, yeah, Louis Erickson probably had his best game of the season so far. He picked a hell of a game to have it in Dallas. And no, I won't mention anything else, but he had a good game. Second period, though, the Bruins get into penalty trouble. And that was really the theme of this game for both teams, but particularly Boston, because the penalty kill couldn't stand up. It was stupid penalty after stupid penalty, interference calls, delay of game. Nothing really went their way, and they certainly didn't help the case with taking just such dumb penalties. Tyler Seguin takes advantage on a power play, his second of the night, to tie this game up at 2. And then Jyrki Jokipaka, the best name in the NHL, he gets his first career NHL goal to put Dallas up 3-2 heading into the third period. And Tyler Seguin would get his hat trick, putting them up 4-2. And Dallas, once again, another power play goal, 4 straight goals. Too much chasing, and Alex Goligoski gets a wide open chance from the high slot. Their third power play goal tonight, and Dallas would take the lead 5-2. The Bruins would get one back. Louis Erickson again does get his second goal of the game to make it 5-3. But the Dallas Stars, who lost the night before in Toronto, much like Arizona did, clearly there's a difference between Dallas and Arizona. And guys, that's pretty much it for this video. There's not really too much more I can say. Chris Kelly's career as a Boston Bruin, or maybe his career in general, is done. David Pastrnak is out. The penalty kill is shit. The Tyler Seguin deal was shit. But again, it's not the end of the world. And yes, I am concerned, though, as I mentioned in the previous video, just how brutal this November schedule could be. They didn't get off to a good start. But we've seen this team come through. They need to step up now. You don't have Chris Kelly. That's an opening for another young player to potentially step in. Potentially Alexander Kuklachev himself to stay in the lineup. There are a lot of young players that can be battling, particularly for a fourth line spot with Ronaldo and Jonas Kempainen, and even Tyler Randall might get back into the lineup there. But I'm going to cut this off. This has gone on way too long. I will see you guys next time when the Bruins play Alex Ovechkin and the Washington Capitals. But good news, it's on the road, so they have a chance. I'll see you all next time.